Hello everyone, most intros are in fact trash, so let's just get straight into the video. You may be wondering, Critic, is that your old sexy ass intro you used to do because you couldn't be fucked to write an interesting opening sentence for your videos? Why, yes it is. How observant of you. You keep giving a gal all this attention and I might have to invite you back to my place. I just thought in the spirit of rehashing dead and buried ideas, we'd bring back some old things from my old videos. Especially these sexy ass drawings. I mean, what would I do without these Picasso-esque drawings? I just can't be bothered to evolve as a media creator. I mean, why try new things when clearly staying stagnant is the new hip thing to do? Everyone loves it when you stifle your own creativity in order to play it safe. Let's talk about the new Lady and the Tramp. Lady and the Tramp is the latest live-action and animation hybrid from Disney, if we can even call this shit animation anymore. It follows the story of two young puppers from different sides of the track meeting and falling in love with one another. But, oh no, they better watch out for the crazy and kooky dog catcher who is definitely not on copious amounts of ketamine.
Ketamine I must do!
The biggest complaints I've heard about this remake is that the dogs are no longer fuckable. If that's your biggest complaint with this film, then hey, no judgment here, I'll just ask that you immediately turn yourself into the FBI, you grotesque furry degenerate. This film is directed by Charlie Bean, director of the critically acclaimed Ninjago movie, and stars Tessa Thompson, Justin Theroux, Benedict Wong, and Sam Elliott. This video will contain spoilers, but you don't care, and if you do, I'm just here to tell you it's okay, maybe your mom will take an interest in you someday. I'm sorry, but you shouldn't care about spoilers for a plot that is 64 years old. Because yeah, of course they didn't change anything about the main story, because why would they? That would require actual effort and care.
Street dog?
Street dog?
I want to use this section to talk about the cinematography and how things just don't pop, but I'm going to have to address this now. I can't avoid my fears any longer if I want to grow as a person. The dogs talking is maybe the single most horrifying and hilarious thing I've seen all year. If you get anxiety bad, I genuinely don't know if I can recommend this film for you to watch. I mean, hell, I wouldn't recommend it in the first place, but I thought it was going to devolve into some Lovecraftian nightmare at any moment.
Where's my spaghetti and meatballs, Tony?
I'm convinced Disney doesn't know how to make animated live-action animals talk properly, but they keep doing it anyways. It's like if aliens were running an Earth restaurant, but all the food they produced was red and smelled like Amy Schumer. I mean, it seems okay, but there's just something very off-putting about the whole thing. Outside of my issue I have with the dogs and how they look while they talk, another issue I have is with the camera work in general. You know what? Say what you will about the live-action Lion King remake, I know I had a few unkind words about Jon Favreau's magnum opus, but at the very least, the camera work wasn't static and awful. Because Disney is working with live-action dogs, they can't move the camera as dynamically as they would like to. So not only are we having to stare at these emotionless mutts who invoke no semblance of feelings from the audience, we aren't even moving the camera around during those scenes. Next you'll say,
"Come on, Critic, there's at least one more visual problem. Hurry the shit up so I can get the dinosaur chicken nuggies my mom made me."
Well, listen here, not only does that sound delicious, my fellow gamer brother, we do in fact have one more glaring problem with the visuals. Let's just be patient. This is a problem I really only notice when looking at some other movies and the original Lady and the Tramp in comparison. This world doesn't feel lived in, there isn't any texture. A lot of the frames in this remake are very clean with cleanish backgrounds. There isn't much to look at in each shot besides the principal character the shot is focusing on. With the animated film, each frame is a painting, so the artist gets to add so many different things to keep the attention of the audience and to make the world feel tangible. With this new movie, I guarantee the budget went mostly to animating the live-action dogs' mouths, so now each scene has the bare minimum when it comes to props, furniture, and just things in general. It almost feels like I'm watching a theater production of Lady and the Tramp, as the sets feel sort of barren. I mean, the performances remind me of a high school theater production as well, so at least it's consistent.
Before any young, destined for Hollywood actors or actresses get offended, I was in high school theater and I'm a shitty actor. I get to make that joke.
Just kidding, you fucking morons. I'm the greatest actor of all time, you stupid dumb shits.
Oh no, it's Officer Trusty. Help. Just in the nick of time.
Do you guys like watching speedruns? I don't. They make me feel inferior as a gamer, and as a gamer, I feel oppressed enough as is. I don't even enjoy trying to speedrun games. I do, however, enjoy doing speed, which seems close enough. So let's go through as many of the things I dislike or like about this film as quickly as possible before we get to my big boy main point. As I was saying a little earlier with the performances, oh my, they are so bad. Justin Thorax might have been one of the biggest miscastings I've seen in quite some time. Tessa Thompson manages to sound like this is her first day of acting, which is weird because she is one of the best relatively new actresses working right now. Sam Elliott sounds like he's three more lines away from fading into the great beyond, and it just makes me sad. I've been a really big meanie head for most of this video, so I gotta say, the song they used to replace the outdated Siamese cat thing is actually pretty good. I imagine Walt Disney himself directly supervised this portion of Lady and the Tramp. Ahahahahaha, Walt Disney would definitely shoot me for my skin tone. If this was in the original film, I'd really like it. But, and I say this with a sad heart, it doesn't work here. The CGI mouth moving on the cats is by far the worst out of any of the animals, and the flow of the song doesn't necessarily work in live action. It's a shame because it's sort of a jam. No more Mr. Nice Critic, we gotta talk about my least favorite aspect of this masterpiece. You know what I loved about the original film? The pacing. It's so slow and it takes its sweet damn time. It feels like a short amount of time in the world of this film's universe. No rush. No hurry, just moving along at a slow pace. This slow pace is far from boring as well. In order to update this for modern day zoomers, we can't allow the audience to enjoy the day with our characters. We have to move things along at a much faster pace. Damn, millennials are probably making avocado toast while watching our movie. We can't just sit with the characters and enjoy the atmosphere. That's boring, Mr. Bob Iger, sir. There's also just a bunch of small things that bother me. Like the way they shot Lady being hit by the door in the beginning of the film, it's just done so lazily. Darling Dear's song no longer feels like a lullaby. It feels poppy and modern. It sounds like it was also filmed in a separate location, as the audio channels sound different. The way the dogs look when they laugh, especially Lady, is absolutely bizarre. What about when the patrons inside the restaurant acknowledge the dogs eating spaghetti? Because every live-action remake has to provide some sort of commentary on how silly the original film is, when 45 minutes ago, you had an absolute unit of a dog catcher chasing a dog through a tram. That is ridiculous. Or how about the way they tried to play off Tramp being surrounded by dog catchers and escaping as being epic? Tramp definitely secured the epic victory royale. I just hate this movie so much.
I got my collar.
I got it.
I'm all for deviating from the source material. If I wasn't, every review I made of a comic book movie would be me screaming and crying for 30 minutes straight as I slowly wait for the madness to consume me. The new Lady and the Tramp is surprisingly all about changing lots of little things. The problem is that changing all these minor details actively hurts the film. Why, you may ask? Well, this is because the main ideas and themes from the original are recycled in the remake. All the little things that were added in the original film to bolster the themes and main ideas are now changed and actively hurt the main purpose of this new film, because they use the same main purpose. Lady and the Tramp is what I would describe as a slice of life film. It feels quite grounded. Well, as grounded as you can get with a movie about talking dogs, but it focuses on just how human these animals can be. It's probably one of the strongest cases of an animated film feeling distinctly of our reality. They still keep this idea of just how human the dogs can be, but now that everything has been shifted, this no longer works. They've exaggerated Lady and Tramp. These two characters felt incredibly human, but now that they've been exaggerated, they felt like cartoon characters. and that doesn't work if you're trying to show just how human the dogs can be. Lady is now more entitled and snobby, which is weird because Aunt Sarah implies that Jim isn't even rich, which goes against the whole class divide idea. Tramp is actively stealing from people and is honestly a bad individual for part of this film. He isn't even brave anymore. The other dogs imply they don't even like him very much until the Tramp song, which goes against the implications from earlier. The dogs no longer feel like characters but cartoons, which is funny, because the whole point of a live-action remake is to ground the story in characters. Everyone in this film has become exaggerated, especially the fucking dog catcher. I think he is my least favorite change in this film. The original film was just filled with people, which made the setting more believable. You didn't have an omnipotent clown of a dog catcher who is now comedic relief. You just had a dog catcher. They even tried to redeem the man who sells the muzzle to the ant and make him a sympathetic character. In the original film, he was just a man doing his job. The ant is now an opera-singing cartoon character who is somehow the worst person on this planet. In the original, she was a mean character, but she was still believably mean.
Critic, are you saying you don't want cartoon characters to act like cartoons?
First off, fella, you sound like the kind of individual who is still being fed via airplane. Second, no. The main point of the film is the same as the original, so making the characters more cartoonish hurts the overall purpose. This also hurts the different sides of the track love story we've got going on. In the original film, the poor dogs and the rich dogs weren't super different in terms of personality. They all just existed. In this new film, the poor dogs are actively looked down upon and have insults thrown their way. They're all thieves and hurt others to get food. The rich dogs now feel snobbish, as if they're riding the highest of horses. This means that Lady and the Tramp falling in love no longer feels earned. Their differences are too distinct now. They aren't more similar than they think. They're just wildly different. It feels impossible to find the common ground between the rich and the poor dogs now. It feels impossible to find the common ground between Lady and Tramp. None of it feels cohesive. None of these changes make sense. Why does Tramp need to steal food if he's still well-liked by all the other restaurant owners? I genuinely don't understand the addition of having him steal to eat. It makes no logical sense. Why does the collar have less importance in this version? It makes the payoff at the end when Tramp is given a collar much less satisfying. I would be down for all these changes if they weren't lazy and decided to change the overall mood, message, and purpose of this film. But these things are factory produced at this point. No use in asking Disney to change the Krabby Patty secret formula when it's still commercially viable. This is just sad.
When the baby moves in, the dog moves out.
Disney's Lady and the Tramp is an expected disaster that shows how far gone the benevolent creators of Whimsy have fallen. Almost nothing about this film works because it doesn't understand the film it's originally based on. Plain and simple, this is a complete and abject failure. I give Lady and the Tramp a 2 out of 10. It's very bad. I would recommend this film to anyone and everyone who likes the original Lady and the Tramp, only if it were worse and longer for some reason. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to support me on Patreon, that would be greatly appreciated. You can follow me on Twitter or join my Discord. Have a great day. Subscribe, hit the bell, and farewell.